Hi, this is Dr. A. In this video, we are going to talk about the pathologies of the skeletal system. All right, so we're going to start with bone pathologies. Chondroma is a tumor in cartilage. It's usually benign. Ewing's sarcoma is a cancerous tumor of the shaft of a long bone. It spreads through the periosteum, and amputation is necessary to prevent metastasis or the spreading of the cancer to other organs. Exostosis is a bone spur. Myeloma is a tumor forming in the bone marrow of the tissue. There's a disease called multiple myeloma. Osteochondroma is a tumor that consists of bone, that's osteo, and cartilage, that's chondro, and oma always means tumor. It is usually benign. Osteogenic sarcoma is the most common type of bone cancer, and it begins in the osteocytes. An osteoma is a tumor found in bone tissues. And osteomalacia is the abnormal softening of bones. It is caused by calcium deficiency, which is caused in children by insufficient sunlight and vitamin D, which you get from sunlight. Osteomyelitis is an inflammation of the bone in the bone marrow. So osteo is bone and myelo is bone marrow. Osteopathy is a general term for bone disease. Osteoporosis is a decrease in bone mass. It results in the thinning and weakening of bones, and the porous bone then easily fractures. Paget's disease is a metabolic disease of the bone of unknown cause. It results in bone destruction and deformity. Rickets is another bone disease. It is caused by calcium and vitamin D deficiency, and it results in bone deformities like bowed legs and children. So this would happen as they grow. So let's talk about some spinal column pathology. We have ankylosing spondylitis. So it is an inflammatory condition that resembles rheumatoid arthritis, where you have a gradual stiffening and fusion of the vertebrae and the spinal column. The herniated nucleus pulposus, or HNP, is a protrusion of an intervertebral disc, also called a ruptured disc. Kyphosis is an abnormal increase in the curve of the thoracic spine. It is also referred to as humpback, so a hunched position here. And lordosis is an abnormal increase in the forward curvature of the lumbar spine, and it's also called swayback. The one thing that makes me think of lordosis all the time is if you see models in windows of clothing stores, they always have like their hips forward and their shoulders back, and so that's kind of a lordosis type of position. And then scoliosis is a lateral curve of the spine, so kind of an S shape of the spine that's abnormal. It should be pretty straight, right? So here is kyphosis or humpback. We have lordosis, or this excessive anterior curvature, so there's too much curve here. And then the scoliosis right there is a lateral curvature here of the spine. So hunchback, swayback, and then scoliosis. And so it's an S shape, but it's lateral. Some more spinal column pathology. So we have spina bifida. It's a congenital anomaly, so something that a baby is born with. And the vertebra fails to fully form around the spinal cord. And so the spinal cord can be sticking out. The spinal stenosis is a narrowing of the spinal canal. So that causes pressure on the spinal cord and the nerves that come out of the spinal cord. Spondylolisthesis is the forward sliding of a lumbar vertebrae over the vertebrae below it. So it's, you know, the slip disc, if you will. Spondylosis is a general term for the degenerative vertebral column condition. So it can be anything any different any condition where there's a degeneration of the vertebrae. Whiplash is a cervical muscle and ligament sprain, often occurs in car wrecks. And then lastly, we have joints pathology. We have a bunion, is an inflammation of the bursa at the base of the great toe. Then we have a dislocation where the bones in a joint are displaced from normal alignments. So we can have a joint dislocation. And then gout is a type of arthritis that is presenting as pain and swelling. It is usually in the first metatarsophalangeal joint. This is a fancy way, medical way of saying in your big toe. It usually shows up in your big toe. And this is due to uric acid crystals that will crystallize in the joint, and that's what causes pain. And then osteoarthritis, it results in the degeneration of bone and joints because of inflammation. So itis has to do with inflammation. And so osteo is bone, arthro is joints, and once you have osteoarthritis, the bones rub against bone, so it's bone on bone instead of cartilage on cartilage with the joint fluid in between. Osteoarthritis tends to happen in joints that have suffered damage, especially maybe a sports injury. Then later on in life, these joints can develop osteoarthritis. Pre-patellar bursitis is swelling of the bursa between the patella, which is a kneecap, and the skin. And is seen in a person who kneel often, so they spend a lot of time on their knees. Rheumatoid arthritis, or RA, is an autoimmune inflammation of the joints with swelling, stiffness, pain, and it results in joint deformities. And here the autoimmune reaction is attacking and destroying the joint membrane, the cartilage, etc. A sprain is a damage to ligaments around the joint due to overstretching. There is no dislocation or fracture with a sprain. And a subluxation is an incomplete dislocation, so the joint alignment is disrupted, but the ends of bones remain in contact. So incomplete dislocation for that one. And then systemic lupus erythematosus is an autoimmune disease of the connective tissue that affects many systems and may include joint pain. It looks somewhat like rheumatoid arthritis. They're both autoimmune, so there's some similarities. And then talipes is a congenital deformity of the ankle with misalignment. It's also known as club foot. So that should be wrapping up our joints pathology. And I will see you in the next video with diagnostic and therapeutic procedures. Thank you.